Our subpoenas are not optional.
In what has become an unprecedented partisan abuse of legislative power, the Democrats have made a series of moves intended on undermining the executive office at the expense of the levers of our constitutional republic.
We are some 34 days since the Mueller report was made public. This is the number of days that the Trump administration has been above the law.
The impeachment process is going to be inevitable. It's just a question of when, not if.
My position on impeachment is what it has always been, and that is the President of the United States of America needs to be impeached.
In the epicenter of the madness, Washington, D.C. impeachment zealots are scurrying around the hallowed halls of Congress in a desperate bid to distract the public from the growing panic regarding the Spygate investigation into the Obama administration that could pull the rug out from under the Democrats' chances in the upcoming election.
You look at the origin of the investigation, where it started, how it started, who started it, whether it's McCabe or Comey or a lot of them. The Mueller report, I wish, covered the oranges, how it started.
Just asking about DOJ investigating the origins of the Russia probe. Do you think they'll find anything, any wrongdoing on the part of the Obama administration?
I have no idea what DOJ is doing. Thanks.
Do you have any comment on them exploring the origins of the Russia probe, investigating the investigators? Do you think it's a worthy cause to do that?
I'm not commenting. Thank you.
Let's remember who Mr. Barr is. Let's examine his conduct. And let's treat his statements in this new investigation for what they really are. Treat them like Trump reelection campaign press releases, because that's what this is about.
But what do
this
you do about it?
This is about distracting from... Well, we need the media to be sure that they point this out, that this is an attorney general who is clearly acting like President Trump's own Roy Cohen, who thinks he's there to defend the president.
Associated Press reports President Donald Trump granted Attorney General William Barr new powers to review and potentially release classified information related to the origins of the Russia investigation. Trump explicitly delegated Barr with declassification power, noting it would not automatically extend to another attorney general and only for use in the review of the Russia investigation. Before using the new authority, Barr should consult with intelligence officials to the extent he deems it practicable.
The concern from Democrats seems to be that Barr can't be trusted and there might be selective release of information. Does that pretty much sum up the worry about him?
Yeah, that's a fair concern. I mean, when you have someone else who's outside their organization now able to say, for whatever reason, I'm going to now... it's declassified, but also potentially make it public. That's very scary to other intelligence agencies.
Outside of Washington, D.C., congressional state Democrats are wreaking havoc on the future of the presidential election, whether their constituents want it or not. 18 states are considering bills that would require presidential candidates to disclose their taxes in order to be on the 2020 election ballot. Out of those 18 states, only Vermont would require candidates for governor and other statewide offices to disclose at least part of their tax returns. The Democrats creating legislation that only applies to others, not to their own corrupt tax returns. Meanwhile, as the Washington Times reports, the Nevada Senate approved a national popular vote bill. The bill intends on undermining the Electoral College and now goes to Democratic Governor Steve Sisolak's desk. Assembly Bill 186 would bring Nevada into the National Popular Vote Interstate Compact. Nevada would become the 16th jurisdiction to join the compact, along with 14 states and the District of Columbia. The 2020 presidential election is shaping up to be a complete mess. John Bound reporting.